Hello, my name is Emily Wonko, and I am the Thesis and Dissertation Clerk here at Sam Houston State University, and you are watching the template training video. To get started, we're going to go to the Thesis and Dissertation website, and to get there, you should start at shsu.edu, which is the Sam Houston homepage. We're going to scroll down to the library under resources. And then on the right-hand side, we're going to go to Writing and Citing and Theses and Dissertations. So this is the Thesis and Dissertation website. Most of your questions can be answered here. This is the home page where you can see the general SHSU guidelines, and right here is where you would find the templates. Here are the macro-enabled templates. These are for PCs, Dells, Windows, stuff like that, not Macs. And you also have the journal style version and then the templates without macros. So this is where you will download the template from. Okay, so now we've found the templates. We are going to locate the template we need, click on it, and it will bring up something that looks like this. This error, no document variable supplied, will be filled in when we begin filling in the information for this. And that is done by using the smiley face button up here in the SHSU Thesis tab. We're going to click it. We're going to hit next. We're going to put our name in, Jane M. Doe, graduation, month and year. We're going to put a title. We're going to get Masters of Fine Arts, name of the department, art, major, coloring. And now they want you to have your directors and readers. This will be your committee chair, your mentor, anybody else will go in this section. Dwayne Johnson, and this is where you select their education. We have two readers, and change her education. One more reader. Okay, now we have the department, the College of Fine Arts, and his John Doe, full name of the dean of the college, and then his education. We're gonna click OK. I've got it. Now you can see that this is filled in all of the information that was blank before. It automatically filled in your department, filled in your degree, filled in your name, your graduation date, your committee members, and when you scroll down, it's automatically filled in the abstract as well. You still need to enter the text and you still need to enter the keywords, but this has been filled in. If something went wrong or you need to change something or you misspelled something, just click this again and re-edit it in the box and click OK, OK again, and it will go ahead and update the section that is wrong. Okay, now we're going to talk about the SHSU thesis pane. We're going to look at this one. This has everything you need to make this as easy as possible. The navigation pane, when you click it, it brings this up. This is very important. When your document gets to 100 pages, you're going to want to be able to click through these and use them at your discretion. It also has your headings. These are very important to use because they will connect your words and your chapters to your table of contents, which is much easier than trying to create one on your own. You also have the custom table buttons, which is important to use because this will connect them to your list of tables and keep them in order. You have the figure and the figure caption. This will also automatically update your figures to your list of figures. So then you have the landscape page if you were going to make one. Those are suggested for large tables, large figures. And then you have the edit name title committee, the smiley face button that we went over. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is start with the headings and the new chapter button. Now we're going to use the headings section of the SHSU thesis tab to use the headings in the new chapter button. We're going to title this one the beginning because that's where you start in a chapter. So this is your chapter number, your chapter title. The first thing that you're going to do for the next one is you're going to create your heading 2, which will automatically populate. And that should be capitalized, but we're going to leave it. So there's your first one. You're going to put some information underneath it. Okay, so there's that one. If you need a second one, you're going to add a heading 3. So here is the next heading. We're going to start in kindergarten. And this is where you're going to put your information. Right there. Now we're going to go to the chapter 2. They only give you 2 pre-populated chapters, so you are going to need probably to add more chapters, because odds are you're going to have more than 2. So the best way to do that is to go... Can I just add one? Ooh, I didn't do that right. So we're going to do that, and then we're going to click down here. We're going to add a new chapter. Boom, it gives you a new chapter on the next page. And now it's automatically updated in your table of contents. That way you can keep track of all of them. Okay, now we have named our chapters. We've gotten some headers in there. Now it's time to update the table of contents. So here's your table of contents. There's 2 ways. You can either hit update all on here and it should update. Now it matches your other chapters. Or you could right click, select the whole thing. Right click, and then there'll be an update button. You can do it that way. So that is something you should do every time you add a new chapter or a new heading. You should update your table of contents. Do it that way. Do not do it by hand. It will take way too long. The next thing we're going to do is add a table. As you can see, our list of tables is blank. So we are going to go add a table. Go to chapter 1, we're going to do a custom table. We want 4 of these, 4 columns, however many you need, click OK. And here is your automated table. So the table number is correctly formatted, it will be correctly numbered. You need to click, this is my table, there's your title. You don't have to have this note, you can get rid of it if you don't need it. You're gonna fill out some information there, and then some numbers. Okay, and you are going to hit update all. Now we're going to go back to the list of tables, and here is your first table with the title correctly formatted and the page number automatically updated. This is the way you should do all of your tables. Please make your tables in Word. It's much easier to make them here than it is to make them somewhere else and then try and transport them in, because the numbering will be off and the formatting will be off. This is the best way to do it, and it will keep them numbered. It will keep them in formatting, and it will keep them within the margins. Okay, now that we have a table, the next thing we're going to do is add a figure. And we're going to do that with the new figure button. Here is the figure number, the figure caption, the information that it may need. You can fill all of these in right here. This counts it automatically. You can click here and insert a picture. We're just gonna title it. This is my figure. And then to make sure that everything went in smoothly, we're just gonna hit update all, and we're gonna go check on the list of figures. Here is your first figure and its page number, all correctly formatted. Definitely use these. If the figure is too big to comfortably see in a page like this, you need to have a landscape page by clicking the landscape page and then following the instructions on the thesis and dissertation website to put the page number in the correct place. Other than that, this is how you format your figure using the SHSU Thesis tab. Alright everyone, that is the end of this template training video. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact me at nglthesis@shsu.edu. I am open to answering your questions and helping you with your documents at any time. If you are doing a journal style document, there is a journal style macros template available on the Thesis and Dissertation website. This training should carry over well to that. Please don't hesitate to reach out if you need me. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you have a great day.